Okay, so the other day my mom comes over, as she does.
Mm-hmm.
And my mom's not mobile. She's got like a walker. She's not ginger on her feet. She's kind of clodding around behind that. She wants to get one of those walkers that actually surrounds you 360 degrees. She's trying to get Esther to buy her one on Amazon. She's completely helpless right now, poor lady. Like, you know, she needs help with everything. But now she wants one of those walkers. Literally.
I don't think I've seen those.
They've got like wheels that, you know, just like ball wheels, right? And then it's literally a round thing and you open it up and clamp it around yourself.
Well,
and
then, whatever helps.
Yeah, I guess. Sure, why not? Look like you look like an old lady in a UFO is what my mom just zipping around Atlanta in a circular.
Hey, at least you're mobile.
Okay, I agree. We're gonna get it. We've just been kind of dragging our feet. So she comes over for dinner, and we sit at the big table, which is here in my dining room. Under my dining room table is a carpet, one of those like decorative rugs.
Yes,
and we have hardwood floors. And that decorative rug was in our bedroom at one point in another house. And then we brought it here and we decided we wanted to put it under there.
Yeah.
You know how my nose is so sensitive?
Mm-hmm.
The entire meal, I was like, God damn. Is that my mom? What smells like that? Is that her walker? Is that Matthias? Did Mia shit herself? And then rub it on a dead raccoon? I mean, it just smells awful. But I can't identify the stank.
All of a sudden, there's Nico.
Well, no, Nico wasn't even there. He was outside.
Well, he's the ghost dog.
He's the ghost dog. Yeah, his spirit. He was there in spirit and smell. Nico. He's just like, he really is. Have you seen his new haircut?
I did. It's cute. He kind of looks like a Scotty now.
He looks like a gremlin. What are you talking about?
That's his Halloween look.
That was just me in the shower with him. Like, I had to give him a bath, and he had hair over his eyes, but some of it was knotted, so I just started taking the scissors. There's no rhyme or reason. I'm going to put a picture of this. Yeah,
he's gone punk.
He looks awful. He looks like a homeless person. That's what he looks like. So he's nowhere to be found. And so after everybody leaves, you know, I have to investigate the smell. So yes. I check Mia's ass, nothing. I check Matthias' feet, nothing. You know, my mom doesn't smell. She takes a shower, right? It's not ass or it's not me. And then so I get under the table and I'm like, like a little rat down there. And I get closer and closer. I can
to the source.
Yes. And then what I notice is directly under the table. There is like a circular spot that has this smell that is death. It smells like death. Do you remember the old joke you have the breath of 1,000 asses? This carpet has the smell of 1,000 asses. It's awful. And then I realized that Nico doesn't sleep in our room anymore. He sleeps outside. And that's where he sleeps. He sleeps right there. So that stench is literally soaked into the carpet. Burn that carpet. No one's going to take that. No one's going to take that carpet. You can't dry clean that out. That doesn't come out. This stink doesn't come out. And all of a sudden, Matthias, my son, has gotten really friendly with Nico.
Yeah.
Matthias could give a shit about those dogs for like 2 years of his life. Like he was the very beginning, he was fascinated. And then he kind of got into his own thing. And then, you know, dogs are just hanging around.
Yeah.
Now all of a sudden he is super fascinated with Nico. Aww. He's real gentle with him because Nico will bite you if you get too close. Like he's like a really skittish dog. And so Matthias goes over and he like walks up slowly and he'll lay with him and like pet him. Aww. It's so sweet. But I got me thinking. Does Matthias like have like an intuition that this dog is on the way out the door? Like, is he have, you know what I'm saying?
He's already gone.
Huh?
I think he's already gone.
Well, that's true.
He's already gone.
But
he's just,
I think that his actual bones apparition. Might be going away too. I think his spirit long since left, but I think his bones might be on the way too. Aww. And I was like, oh, the kids are going to be crushed. Mia loves that dog.
Yeah.
And you know, now Matthias loves that dog. But luckily, I have investigated this and I understand that there is a way that we can figure this out.
Okay.
Because in certain countries in Asia and in Europe right now, they are allowing you to clone your pet.
Oh, that's right. I saw an article
about
this.
Did you see this?
Yeah.
This is fucking insane.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think this is good.
Nico 2.
Yeah, Nico 2.0. What if he comes back with the same smell and skittish, like, What if he comes back smelling worse than he did before?
It could be a possibility.
What if it literally is inherent in the Nico? Like just Nico just smells. It's not the, it's not his teeth. It's not his, we're trying to get to the bottom of what all the smells are. We know his mouth smells bad, but it's just like, he just generally, Nico just smells, right? Mm-hmm. What if it's not any of those things? It's just Nico is literally emanating.
Yeah.
Like.
That's the chance you take if you get him close.
Nico smells, you know, when you see a crushed turtle on the way to the beach, Nico smells like a, like what I think a crushed turtle would smell like.
I haven't seen a crushed turtle.
You never seen a crushed turtle?
No, and in fact, I've actually moved turtles out of the way that I've encountered on roads.
Me too. High five. Yep, that's a good thing. Yep, I do that all. I do that too. Mm-hmm. If I see one, if I pass, I have been driving like 78 miles per hour down the road in the back roads of Florida. You go wherever I'm going, and I have seen a turtle
barreling down.
Oh
the back
my god,
roads
dude! I go so fucking fast when I get on those back roads. There ain't no cops back there. They don't give a shit. I'm just hauling at two children sleeping in the back of the car, and I'm going 112, half asleep, listening to Howard Stern. I got it on cruise control. I don't give a shit.
Oh my god!
Please God, if I go, let it be easy.
But if you see a turtle, then you
but if
stop.
I see a turtle, I wake up too. And I stop. Yeah. And then I take off 0 to 110
the
seconds.
Metal.
Yeah, of course. Why not? Yeah. Shit. I mean, if you're not going to open it up there, where will you open up? It's flat. It's long. You know, there's no curves. Florida's a different kind of driving experience than here in Georgia. But so you can clone your pet. Was this something you would do? I don't think so. I think this is a bad thing. I actually don't think cloning is a great idea.
I agree.
Yeah. Because no. I think it can lead to
scary.
I
had a beloved cat, Patches. You knew Patches.
Oh, yeah. Patches.
Patchy.
Good old Patchy.
Patches. Yeah. I had her since I was like 10.
Yeah. And she lasted until you were like 35.
Well, that's what I was going to say. Yeah. She was 22.
That's crazy.
Yeah. And as much as I love her and miss her, in fact, I still have dreams about her where she pops into my dreams. And and in my dream, I'll say, oh my gosh, Patches, I'm so happy to see you, but I haven't fed you in years and I haven't cleaned your litter in years. How have you been surviving? But anyways, there was a one and only Patches, and I don't know if I'd want to clean her as much as I love you.